Hello and welcome. Today on the menu, we have this delicious rich palak gosht, also known as spinach mutton curry. Believe me you guys, once you make mutton like this, you'll definitely forget all other ways. It's that yum. My whole family loved this and I hope you guys will relish it too. It's a must try. So let's get cooking. So here I am boiling 1 liter of water, to which I'll be adding 250 grams of spinach. We'll blanch it for around 2 to 3 minutes. Once the spinach is nice and soft, I'll take it in a clean bowl and will transfer to a mixer grinder. As you can see, this has turned out to be a nice and silky paste. We'll keep it aside for further use. So onto a hot kadhai, I'm adding 3 tablespoons of ghee, a pinch of asafoetida or hing, you can also take hing powder. In dry whole spices, I have taken 2 bay leaves, little cumin, 4 cloves, 2 black cardamom, 4 dry chilies and a cinnamon stick. We'll saute it for 30 to 40 seconds till the aroma comes out. So here I have taken 4 to 5 medium onions which are chopped. We are going to saute them for like 15 to 20 minutes or till they are nice and golden brown. While the onions are getting sauteed, I'm adding here 1 tablespoon of salt. This will definitely accelerate the frying process. You see this nice golden color? This is what we were looking for. Now it's time to add ginger and garlic paste. I have taken 1 cup of ginger and garlic paste and we'll saute it for around 10 to 15 minutes. So now I'm going to add 3 to 4 slit green chilies. Along with this, I'm going to add powdered spices like 1 tablespoon each of red chili powder, turmeric, garam masala and coriander powder. Now we are going to saute it for another 10 to 15 seconds. Now it's time to add the mutton. So here I have taken pre-boiled mutton, which I have boiled it for around 4 to 5 whistles till the mutton is 80% cooked. Once everything is mixed properly, we'll cook the mutton with the lid for 15 minutes and without the lid till 80% of the water is evaporated. So now at this stage, we are going to add our spinach puree which we have already prepared. So I am adding around 6 to 7 tablespoons of spinach puree and we'll be cooking it for another 5 to 10 minutes till the spinach gets cooked properly. So after all the patience, you get this. You see the oil losing out, guys? This is what we want. But we are not done yet. The most important part of the recipe is adding a cup of milk to the mutton curry. Believe me guys, do not skip on this part. This is very important part of this recipe and this will change the game completely. So now cover it for 6 to 7 minutes and you will get this. I can't explain you guys how good my kitchen smells right now. Doesn't this look really tempting? So now just few final touches and then we are done. Here I am adding 1 tablespoon of white butter and kasuri methi. So I have dry roasted the kasuri methi for around 30 seconds and now I am sprinkling it all over. I mean just look at the texture of this gravy. This is definitely one of my personal favorites. and anyone who enjoys and relish mutton will definitely love it. You can enjoy this palak gosht with either parantha, roti or even with rice. It tastes equally delicious. Now I'm topping it up with a little bit of fresh cream. So guys, do try this recipe at home and let me know in the comments down below. Enjoy!